let's talk about I'm a Celebrity Kid, because we loved you for that. You silver medalist. Did you think you were going to win at any stage?
No. Every morning I had my bag packed. I was like, okay, today's my day. And they're like, Ashley, it's not you. And I was like, what the heck is going on? I was really surprised that I stuck it out as long as I did.
Did you know what the show was before you went on it?
No, I didn't do much of my education on that one. No, didn't. I saw one episode of the last season before me.
Right.
And I was like, okay, they jumped out of a plane, they stuck their face in some gooey stuff. I was like, I can do this, I can handle this. I'm going to go do it.
What's the hardest bit?
Oh, I mean, everything is hard. Being so disconnected from the world is really tough because you're like, what time is it? What's going on? I miss my family. How are they doing? You don't know what's going on at all. You know, the food, the hunger, and then just the trials in itself are another level.
What was harder, the trials or understanding what Eric Bristow said?
That might be a toss-up there.
Yeah, did you understand anything he said to begin with?
Towards the end, I started to get bits, but, I mean, in the beginning, I literally was like, I have no idea what he's saying to me right now. I just start going...
I don't know if you saw the edit of that, but there was this one brilliant bit where you just turn to someone and go, what's he saying?
Yeah. Yeah.
Because I've always wondered about the boredom in it. You know, you're a very active person. Yeah. To be 24 hours where really a lot of the time you've got nothing to do.
No, I did a little bit of yoga each day. Not yoga. I mean, I might have taken some of that with me. But I did yoga and a lot of time I was just in my hammock, like staring up like, I wonder what's happening in the world.
Oh, I think we got a clip. We got a clip. We got a clip. We got a clip of you in on.
Okay.
Oh, God. Okay. Think a happy thought. Think about dinner tonight. We're going to have a lovely day. Lovely evening. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Oh, it popped. I heard the pop. Oh, good God. Okay. Just breathe. Just try and... It's okay. You're doing it the style, babe.
I'm like, here's my chicken and vegetables, and I'm straight with that. I don't know. That popping of the eyeball, though, was...
Did they tell you before you went in that every time you took a shower, they were going to take a picture and stick it in the press?
No.
No.
No,
you didn't realize every time you were in a bikini.
David educated me on that, yeah. He was like, every time you go in the shower, give him a slow-mo. I'm like, what are you talking about?
Did he say that?
He did. And then I saw his butt cheeks, and I was like, excuse me. He had a plan there. He knew exactly what he was doing.
Still got bad butt, though, has he?
They're nice cheeks.
Unbelievable. Now, we heard that the thing you hated eating most, though, was corned beef. Is that right?
That was disgusting.
Oh, you see, no, you're wrong about it. This
see, it didn't look like
proper corned beef.
Oh, okay.
Right? Do you eat meat?
Yes.
Yeah, no. Corned beef, basically, the real way of doing it is this, where basically it's kind of cured
so
with salt, and it's kind of dried out.
Okay.
That is proper.
This is not from a can.
No, and it's called corned beef because it's kernels from the salt.
Oh, well, this is
nice. That's beautiful, isn't it? Mm.
This is not what I tasted. This is not even close.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have fed that to my dog.
I actually really like that. My favourite sandwich is that corned beef with cheese and coleslaw.
Yeah, that's...
Let's talk about your single.
Okay.
Out.
Mm-hmm.
Is there an album to go with it?
Yes. Beginning of next year, I'm going to have an album out. Really excited.
Is it all recorded and sorted now, just ready to go, or do you have to finish it?
Almost. I still have stuff to finish, but it's coming out. I'm super excited. As a meeting corn beef.
Will you be basing your music career over here to begin with, or the States, which were?
Over here.
Yeah.
I'm going to push it here first, and then I'll
have why? What's the reason behind that?
I don't know.
We love her. We've got second in the jungle.
Yeah,
I think that, and I've always felt a good connection. You know, with the Dolls as well, we had a really big following over here, and it just... I don't know, it fits well, so, and I love it over here.
How are you with the Pussycat Dolls? Are you all friends now, or do you not talk to
each
other?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, Kimberly and I have been sisters before we even got in the group together, and I still talk to most of the girls, so, yeah. You go through something like that in life, you're always connected.
Well, is it over now, though? Would it ever come back, do you think?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen in the future. I don't. I swear. I don't know what's happening here.
So where are you living?
What?
Where are you living? Naughty boy.
No,
Paris.
All right.
Where do you live now then? Are you living still in LA, or are you living over here?
I live in LA with my dog Cooper, but I'm gonna be back and forth.
Right, because last night you were out in Chelsea with Hugo.
I was, yeah.
Yeah, how was that?
Amazing, you wanted to show me around his little hometown, so it was really cute.
Where did he take you? Anywhere exciting?
Some restaurant, and then Bougie.
Bougie, you went to Bougie. What were the people like in Bougie? Did you like those people?
They were fine. We all just danced, you know, just dancing.
So there's lots of stuff in the paper about you. You're going to be dating English men now. So you come over with
okay.
Is there any truth that you're dating Mark Wright or Anton Deck?
Those are rumors. I just got out of the jungle. I'm like, God, I've been really busy here. It's been like 48 hours. I'm all over the place.
Yeah. Now, we don't want you to be like a GI, come over here, break a few hearts, and then go back to America.
Okay.
If you're out with our Englishman, you ought to settle here.
Oh, okay.
Do you think you could live in England?
Yeah, definitely. Back and forth, I think I'd want to be, but yeah, I love it here.
Yeah.
The sunshine is the only thing that keeps me a little like, oh, I just love the sun. But I love the culture, I love the people.
And who in the jungle were you going to stay friends with, do you think, out of all that lot?
Hugo and David and I are definitely, I feel like, are going to remain friends. Yeah. Charlie is such a sweetheart. She's over in Australia right now, though, so I haven't seen her over here. But she's going to be in L.A. next year. So, yeah, definitely. Rosemary wants to teach me how to cook, so
yeah.
I
what
might
was
take up
like?
On that.
Any good in the jungle?
Well, you know, what we were given, I don't know if you could have done a whole lot with that. There was no seasoning.
Great, Rosemary. She'd be a great person to cook. She's like a schoolmistress, isn't she? She's
oh, 100%. I love her.
Yeah.
Like, so sweet. So much fun.
I do love the show. Yeah, we've won a meal, and then you get an alligator's foot. Yeah.
Crocodile feet. You're so excited, and the bag drops, and you're like, all right, kangaroo loins tonight. Yeah.
All right, cheers, actually.